Let's look at the mobile application to control this RC car. As mentioned in the previous video, it was made with Flutter. Let me show you how it works on my Android phone. The source code for this project can be found in the video description below, so please don't worry about not showing all the code in this video. The app is very simple. After connecting BLE, it's simply sending data from the app to ESP32. The home screen is responsible for finding a pre-specified BLE server. If you look at this part of the code, you can check the ESP32's Bluetooth MAC address like this. In the app, you can specify your target Bluetooth device's MAC address in the constants.file. You must update it with yours. Without it, you will not be able to find your target device on your app. As you can see here, it keeps scanning. If your device, your phone's Bluetooth is turned off, you can see this screen. This feature is only available in the Android version and is not currently supported on iOS. After connecting to the target BLE server, it will check if the UUID of characteristic is present or not. I created two connections. One is Notify, which is sent from ESP32 to app, and the other one is TX, which is sent from app to ESP32. The current version simply writes data from the app and ESP32 only gets data. However, since it is already implemented to transfer data from ESP32 to the app, you can use it at any time. Let's talk about the control screen. Luckily, I was able to find a good joystick package. I used this to configure the control screen. The left side was made to move only vertically and the right side was made to move only horizontally. Very intuitively, you control the DC motor via the left handler and the servo motor via the right handler. It is convenient because the knob follows whenever you touch on the screen. This is a screen configuration commonly seen in mobile games. Callback function is called whenever a touch event occurs, and wiring is attempted with the TX characteristic each time. I use a few tricks to minimize BLE traffic. This is very important because it affects the reaction speed of your RC car. I believe you can see that by looking at my code. This RC car project we have worked on so far is a base project based on BLE. As mentioned in the previous video, I made this to play with my son. Of course, my son will get a toy RC car for Christmas and I play with what I made. As you can see here, this RC car has room for various upgrades. First, since it has a camera module, of course it requires a communication method other than BLE, but it can be controlled in another way. Also, I think we can create a more complete RC car by attaching a GPS module or some other sensors. I don't know for now. Anyway, hopefully this project helps your own project as well. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.